Research shows that before a child attains the age of 14, he or she has heard on an average 1,48,000 times, "You can't." Whatever may be the intention of the parents, the teachers, the peer group, the society, but somewhere in trying to be very protective of the child, we have this exaggerated use of "you can't," "you should not," "you will not," "you must not," "not, not, not." We keep communicating. So what happens is, even before you attain the age of 14, you have on an average 1,48,000 times memory cells created within you saying, "you can't." As a result, anytime we endeavor to venture into something ambitious, anytime we look at an ambitious goal, the first thing that happens to us is something within us says, "you can't." And because we seek endorsement, we go and sit with other people and ask other people, "I want to do something as enterprising as this. I want to venture into something innovative as this. I want to be a pathfinder. I want to be a path breaker. I want to do something which nobody else has done." The moment you propose an idea, the world around you, where each one of them by themselves have heard 1,48,000 times, "I can't, I can't, I can't," collectively everybody discourages you from the possibilities of what you can do and what you can be. Visualize a situation where a small ant is climbing up a wall and try to block the path of the ant with the palm of my hands. What will the ant do? It will take a detour and continue to climb. For sadistic pleasure, which is not what I am, but I pushed the ant down from the wall, it falls down, what will it do? It won't stay there dejected and disappointed. It will immediately start climbing the wall one more time. Why? Animals only understand the language of life, and language of life is, "I can." The language of death is, "I can't." For animals, the only time they will say, "I can't," is when they are dead and gone. As long as there is life in them, they continue to believe, "I can." There is a reason behind this. In the parenting of an animal, the lion only teaches her cubs, the lion and the lionesses, they teach their cubs only what they are capable of doing. There's no discussion in that parenting about, "you can't fly, you can't swim." What you can alone is discussed. What happens in a human parenting, in a human situation where you're growing in an environment, is not only you're showed what you can do, but they always remind you of what you can't do. And over a period of time, the language of death, which is "I can't," becomes so dominant in our conditioning, it overrides the "I can" conditioning within us. It seems in one of the schools, a fourth standard class teacher came inside the class and told all the children at the beginning of the academic year, "All of you open your rough notebooks and I want you to list down all the things that you can't do in life." So children started writing, "I can't sing, I can't dance, I can't speak in public, I'm not an orator." In fact, the teacher continued to coax them with some more suggestions on what all they cannot. And each one built their own list. It seems the teacher said, "Rip open that page and come, let's all go to the football ground." And the entire class followed the teacher jogging to the football ground. Then she dug a pit and she told all these children, "Throw all the sheets that you have brought inside this pit." And once they did that, the pit was closed. And it seems with intensity in her voice, the teacher looked at all the children and said, "Now that we have buried what we can't, let's focus on what we can. Let's invest the rest of the academic year, only focus on what we can and not what we can't." This is my call to all of you through this 52 thoughts. Let's bury what we can't and focus on what we can. if animals can commit themselves to a life, speaking the language of life, which is I can, why we, the greatest of all the creations of God, as a human being, should live our life speaking the language of death, which is I can't. Let's believe I can. It seems the research through aerodynamics is conclusive that a bumblebee, because of the size of the body that he has and the wings are disproportionately small, a bumblebee can never fly. But fortunately, a bumblebee does not know there is a scientific research which concludes a bumblebee cannot fly, so a bumblebee keeps flying. We see around us people who, in spite of the judgment of the world, where they always believe that he cannot, she cannot, they have been a bumblebee in their life, they have been a go-getter in their life, they have continued to believe they can, and time and again they have shown it to us, they can. Let's start believing, I can, you can, we can, and walk into a future believing we can, and see what unfolds. All I'm telling you is this: if right now there are things that you want to do in your life and you believe I can't, and we have to reach where we believe I can, let the bridge between I can't and I can be can I expands itself into constant and never-ending improvement in whatever direction. You want to be a dancer and right now you believe I can't dance, commit yourself to constant and never-ending improvement. From today, every day, you will learn something in dance that makes your today look better than your yesterday. You think you can't sing? From today, commit yourself to can I, constant and never-ending improvement. From today, you will learn something, you will practice something by which today you are a much better singer than you were yesterday. We don't have to look around for inspiration. Listen to your own body, and your body will tell you, I can. If your heart has a voice, and this is what your heart will tell you: hey, master of this body, I have been working from the time you were in the womb of your mother, relentlessly, enthusiastically. I, as a heart, will continue to work till you reach the tomb. And your own heart will tell you, if I, just a part of your body, can relentlessly work from womb to tomb, you master of this body, you got to believe you can work to the last breath of your life. You can. Your own hands will tell you, hey, master of the body, we dirty ourselves to keep the rest of the body clean. Anytime anybody tries to hurt any part of the body, we volunteer to take the blow onto us. We take the hurt and protect the rest of the body. And your own hands will tell you, hey, master of this body, we just an organ in your body. If we can feel protective and responsible to the remaining parts of the body, you, as the master of this body, you can take responsibility for all the roles of your life. And you can. Your own digestive system will tell you, hey, master of this body, you eat whatever you want to eat, you drink whatever you want to drink. We retain whatever is good for you and eliminate whatever is bad for you. If we, just a part of your body, can, you, as the master of this body, got to believe in all the things that you get exposed to in life, you can retain what is good for you and eliminate what is bad for you. You can. And most importantly, your own legs will tell you, hey, master of this body, wherever you want to reach, we take you there. Not even once we have failed you to take you where you want to reach. If just a part of your body can take you wherever you want to reach, hey, master of this body, you got to believe, whatever be your goals, whatever be your ambitions, whatever be your desires, you got to believe you can reach them. And you can. From today, a big no-no to the language of death, I can't, and a big yes-yes to the language of life. And the language of life is, I can. Believe me, you can, we can. I love you so much. Thank you.